गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. स्ट्रेस इज द मेजर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग फैक्टर फॉर नंबर ऑफ डिजीजेस. सो टुडे वी विल लर्न रिगार्डिंग स्ट्रेस. दिस स्ट्रेस एंड व्हेन इट इज अराइजेस. दिस स्ट्रेस ऑकर्स व्हेन देयर इज एन एक्सेसिव प्रेशर और डिमांड प्लेस्ड ओवर अ पर्सन. दे कैन नॉट कोप विद दैट सिचुएशन. देयर इज अ रिएक्शन ऑकर्स. दैट रिएक्शन इज नोन एज स्ट्रेस. Two types of stresses are there. Okay, so first is external and internal. External and internal. External factors are physical environment, social interaction, organizational, major life events, and daily hustle. Example for the physical environment is bright light, noise, confined place, excessive heat, cold. So these are some example for the physical environment. These are the things can make cause for the stress for individual person. And another is social interaction. For the social interaction, like bossing, rudeness, aggressive behavior by other persons. So these are the example for the social interaction. While interacting with others, that can also make some stress for the person by the behavior of others. Bossing means when there is an excessive demand from the boss, from the workplace, okay. And another is rudeness from others and aggressive behavior by others can also make the stress for the person. For the organizational examples are rules and regulations, deadlines. In an organization setting, there will be rules, regulations and deadlines for submitting any project. So these may cause the stress for the person under the organizational sector. Examples for this major life events is birth, death, promotions for job, loss of job. So these are the examples for the major life events. Birth, death, promotion, loss of job, these are the main things may cause for the stress. And another is daily hustles. For example, for the daily hustles are commuting, misplacing key or breakdown of the mechanical things. So that may cause stress for the person. Commuting means the travel from the workplace to the home, from home to workplace. They may have to travel from early morning, coming back at midnight. They will not get the satisfied time to spend with the family. So these are the main causes can occur for the stress. Physical environment, example bright light, noise, confined places, heat, cold. If they cannot adjust with these things, they may get stress. And another is social interaction, like example bossing, rudeness, aggressive behavior from others, that may cause stress for the person. And another is organizational, if there is a rules, over demands, and another deadlines for any assignments, projects, and major life events such as birth, death, promotion, and loss of job. Daily hustles like commuting, misplacing key, or breakdown of mechanical things. And these are the examples for this major factor for the external stress. And we'll see about the internal stresses, that is lifestyle, negative self-talk, mind trap, personality traits. Okay, lifestyle, negative self-talk, mind trap, and personality traits. Example for this lifestyle is using of caffeine, overload schedule, disturbed sleeping pattern, okay. So these are the example for the lifestyle. When there is a changes in the lifestyle can cause the stress for the person, okay. Like using of the caffeine, the toxic effect of the caffeine can cause the sleeping disturbances, and it can change the lifestyle. And overload work schedule and disturbed sleeping pattern also one of the main cause for the stress. And the example for the self-talk is pessimistic thinking, self-criticizing, over-analyzing, These are the example for the negative self-talk. Okay, pessimistic thinking means always thinking that something bad will happen for them. Okay, and another is self-criticizing. I am bad. I am not looking good. And something is happening for me. So this kind of self-criticizing is also make one of the stresses. And another is over-analyzing, over-judgment towards others, and over-judgment towards yourself is also make stress for the person. And next is mind trap. For the example of the mind trap is unrealistic expectations. Expectation is always good sometimes, but unrealistic expectation may cause stress because it will not happen, so that will lead to the stress for that person. And next is personality traits. For the personality traits, example is perfectionist and workaholic. Example for the personality traits that the person is always trying to become more perfect in everything, that causes also stress. We were discussing about the types of stresses, that means the factors which can influence the stress, right? So now we can learn about the types of stress. The type of stress, first type is negative stress. So what is this negative stress? If you have a stress and it is unrelieved for a prolonged days, what will happen? It can contribute for the minor diseases such as headache, digestive problem, skin complaint, insomnia, ulcers. So if you have a stress, these are the minor disorders can occur. So if you have a stress and it is unrelieved, please expect to someone and remove those stress from your body. Otherwise you will get like that headache, digestive problems, skin complaints, insomnia, ulcers. Insomnia means sleeping disturbances. Another type of the stress is positive stress. So positive stress is act as a stimulation for the challenging situation because it makes the sense of urgency and alertness which is needed for the confronting threatening situation. Talk about the symptoms of stress. Different symptoms are there: physical symptoms, mental symptoms, emotional symptoms, and behavioral symptoms. Once we talk about the physical symptoms, it is like trembling, sweating, then fainting, dizziness, loss of sexual desire, then infection, digestion problems, skin problems, sleeping pattern disturbances. These are the examples or the symptoms which can occur physically. For the mental symptoms such as confusion, loss of memories, panic attack, and difficulty in making decisions. So these are the example or the symptoms which can occur mentally. Behavioral symptoms like changes in appetite pattern. Like sometimes they won't have the appetite, sometimes they have high level of appetite. And another is eating disorders like anorexia or bulimia. Eating disorder, anorexia means there is no appetite, and bulimia means there is excessive eating disorder. And another symptom is excessive intake of alcohol or over smoking. Other symptoms like depression, impatience, fearfulness, and disturbances in the taking care of personal hygiene. These are the symptoms of emotional symptoms. The stress related diseases are cardiovascular diseases, digestive diseases, skin problems, ulcers, depression, and premenstrual syndrome. So many diseases can occur related to stress.